different strategies for planning production. We have seen the plan or the strategy, which is called the constant workforce. And now we will look at another strategy called the zero inventory plan or the chase strategy, always chasing to try to produce exactly what we need in the different periods. And then we want to find the production for one worker in that particular month, which is the number of days multiplied by the K factor. If one worker produces the number of items defined in the K factor for one day, we can just multiply by the number of days to find the production for one worker in one particular month. Then divide the demand for that month of the to that number to find the exact number of workers which is needed in one month. So we'll now go through the same example as we have seen on the blackboard with and try to use the strategy of zero inventory or the chase strategy to find a new strategy for meeting the same demand as we have seen in the previous example on the constant workforce strategy. So let's try to first we'll just see the demand for the different months. And we remember here that we had a demand of 220, which was the forecast and adjusted with the inventory, incoming inventory. And then just write the numbers here. And now, instead of using the cumulative demand, as we did when trying the constant workforce plan, we will use the demand or the production per month to meet the demand. And we will make a new column, which is the demand, divided by the number of days multiplied by K. So the number of days multiplied by the K factor is what is actually needed, how many workers you need in that particular month. The demand divided by the number of days multiplied by the K factor will then define how many workers you need in that particular month to meet that exact demand shown in the column on the blackboard here. So dividing 220 to the number of days in January and multiplied by the K factor, we will find that we need 29.2. And we can probably round up to 30 workers if we are only considering an integer number. You're not having workers employed in fractional positions. So we can do that for all the other months. In February 1st, we need to produce 280 items. And we have, I don't remember exact number of days, but it was smaller, so 280 divided by the number of days and the K factor will give us a value of 51.2. Here we could, or to be certain to have enough, we should actually round upwards, but we have this situation here that we actually have already rounded in January. And we are having a small overproduction in January to meet the demand in February, which will mean that we actually can round to 51 in this case here. But to be sure, we should round always upwards, because if you have a fraction, it's not always possible to meet the exact demand we need if we are rounding downwards. But in this case, we can actually do that because we have some overproduction in January. And similar, we can do the same for March, April, May, and so on. We will see that March, we remember, was the critical month. We'll only write the integer numbers here. We need 59 workers in March. In April, we need 28. And then we need 43. In June, only 19. In July, 15. And in April, August, 30. So this is now the number of workers we need to produce exactly what we need, or as close as possible as we need to the demand for the different months. And then we have some changes in the workforce. And the workforce was 40 at the beginning of the year, and 40, then in January we should go down to 30, then we have to sack or get rid of 10 people, minus 10, or we can have it in two different columns, I think. So here, plus and minus, and then minus 10 in January, then we have to employ 21 from 30 up to 51 in February. And then we have to employ 8 more in March. Then we need to get rid of 31 in April. Employ 15 in May. And then 24 down in June, and even 4 more in July, and we need to employ 15 more in August.